Hey everyone, my name's Anna. I'm a technical trainer here at SAS, and today I'm going to be talking about merging data sets in SAS. So there's a couple ways to do this. You can use the data step merge, or you can use a PROC SQL join. Now, in this video, we're going to cover PROC SQL or PROC SQL joins using the SQL procedure, just because they're really easy to grasp, and if you have any SQL experience, you're going to pick up on it pretty quickly. But feel free to check out data step merge, also a really cool, powerful tool. So, to get us started, I'm going to just jump into SAS. I've created two data sets. One is called Student Contact, and the other is called Student Grades. These are fictitious data sets for fake students, but we're pretending we work at like a university or maybe a high school, and we've got some data about our students. So if we look at Student Contact, we have a student ID column. We have their name, city, and state. Notice student ID uniquely identifies each of our students. So we have a couple students from Virginia, but we can use their ID to uniquely identify each one. Also, I do want to point out, notice that this data set has 7 records in it. So we have this student ID 127 for Tammy from Boston. All right, let's look at student grades. So in this one, I have a GPA column, I have a couple test scores, and then again, I have that student ID. But like I said, we only have IDs 1 through 6, so 121 to 126. That is important to note. All right, so we want to be able to bring these two data sets together. Maybe we want to be able to get contact info and GPAs so that we can contact some students and say congrats, or hopefully not, but maybe contact some students to say, hey, you need to lift your GPA next semester. So let's go back to our program. And like I said, we're going to use PROC SQL. So that starts with PROC SQL semicolon. And then it ends with a quit statement. In between PROC SQL, you can put a bunch of different statements. You can create tables, you can do describe tables. We're gonna use the select statement, which allows us to write a query, generate results, and pull them back to SAS. So I've got a select clause to start my select statement. And then I'm gonna use a from clause. These are the two clauses that you're required to have. There are plenty more, but that's just what we're gonna focus on. The select allows us to specify the columns we want. The from is where we put the tables, so our data sources. So we're pulling from student contact. And we're also pulling from student grades. Now, these names are really long for tables. I'm going to go ahead and just add an abbreviation that we can reference. This is called a table alias. So if I say as SC for student contact, and then we'll say as SG for student grades, that following our table allows us to reference SC and SG throughout, makes it a little easier for us. All right, now we said we're joining these two data sets, so I'm gonna go ahead and put the join, and then if we're joining data sets, we need a condition or something to bring them together on. So that's gonna use the on clause, and we're gonna say we want the student ID in our student contacts to be equal to the student ID in student grades. Now, quick thing I want to point out here, notice I've specified an inner join. In SQL, an inner join is going to take all the matching rows of data, so all the rows that were created using student IDs that match, student IDs that came from both tables. If that student ID was present in both, that row of data will be present in our inner join. So we're saying we want the student IDs to be equal. Wherever we find the same student ID, a record that matches, we want to see those rows of data. Now we should probably fill out our select so that we actually display some columns. So I'm going to select all my columns from student contact. And to do that, I'm going to give you a quick shortcut. Specify SC period, and then if you just follow that with an asterisk or a star, that's going to pull all the columns from student contact. And then we need a comma. Let's pull the GPA from student grades. So we'll get our contact info and our GPA joined based on student IDs being equal. Oh, I saw an issue here. This should be student ID. That makes more sense. We want our student IDs to be equal. All right, so let's run this program and check out our results. Great, okay, so we can see we have our 6 students here. We have their student ID, student name, city, and state. All of that information came from student contacts, but because we did a join, we were able to pull in this GPA column. Now notice we don't have Tammy's record. We don't have Tammy's information. She was only present in student contact. And we did an inner join, which means we took records that came from both data sets. However, if we want to see Tammy's information, we definitely can. And it's actually a really quick switch. So we can take this word inner here, we're going to change it to left. With the left join, we're saying we want to see all the data that's in our left table. Student contact is the left table because it's to the left of our join type when you read left to right. So we're saying everything is student contact, we want to see that. And then any information that is available from student grades, so anytime that we were able to pull a GPA in, we want to see that as well. So this will give us Tammy, it would give us any students who are in student contact but not in student grades. If I run this section, all right, there's our results. So you can see the first six records look exactly the same. And then we also have Tammy's record here. So we can see we don't have her GPA. Maybe we misrecorded it or forgot to record her record in our student grades data. Maybe she didn't take her finals, which is definitely not good. But now we've seen that we should investigate this record. We need to see where Tammy's GPA is and find that info. So that's how to use PROC SQL to join data sets in SAS. Again, don't forget there is the data set merge, another great tool. Feel free to subscribe to SAS users above and leave any comments below. Definitely check out other videos, and thanks for watching this one. Bye guys.